Child, jump for joy. Don't you grieve, little Eve. All the hounds, I do believe, have been killed. Ain't you thrilled? Jump for joy.
Have you seen Cassia?
That feels better, right?
What were rehearsals like when you were getting ready for the show?
Fun.
I'll bet.
It was always fun with the governor because Gubby was a sweetheart of a guy.
Yeah.
The only time that I can remember when there were times when you just couldn't make contact with him.
And how do you mean?
He was creating and in a creative thing.
Yeah.
You could sit there and talk to him and it sounded like a tape recorder running, you know. He'd answer your questions, but he wasn't there. And sometimes I'd catch him at the hotel. I'd be in the lobby sitting there and he'd come down from the hotel while we were filming. I had a home there, but most, a good deal of them.
Oh, you had a house in Los Angeles?
Yeah, I had a home there. Well, because I came down, I actually came there in 1930. First came there in 1934, and there was an earthquake. I didn't like it, so I went back, and then I came back in 1936 and did the cowboy picture.
I see. So when you say you went back to Chicago?
I went back to Detroit.
Oh, Detroit, I see, yeah.
And Chicago.
Because you were still working with Earl Hines.
And, damn, look at this.
The orchestra, and I assume,
the band was down in the pit, or were they featured on the stage in the show?
The band was in the pit.
In the pit.
And then Duke was directing from the pit.
He was conducting right there.
Because an incident happened.
Oh.
Well, a lot of people weren't aware of this, but one of the financiers that put money behind it was John Garfield.
Uh-huh.
And I had never seen him in person in my life, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I liked his acting, and I liked him, you know, in those days when I was watching the movies, but I've been in Hollywood and worked out in Hollywood and some of the clubs never came in, never met him. But I did meet a lot of stars, a lot of actors by coincidence.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The majority of the ones that I met, it was just I was there, they were there, or things happened like that.
Yeah.
I was in my dressing room one afternoon. I had heard that he was one of the financiers, but I didn't particularly believe it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But he was a big movie star at mm-hmm. that time. So somebody knocked on my door. Mm-hmm. Come in. John Garfield. Looking at him in person, standing there, you know. Couldn't believe it, you know. Whoa, John Garfield. He said, Mr. Jeffries, I'm John. I said, I know who you are. I'm John Garfield. He said, I'm involved in the show. I said, yeah, I heard that you were one of the financiers. Well, he says, I'm involved in the show, let's put it that way. And so he said, I wanted to come in, and we've been talking about this, and I wanted to come in and suggest it to you and see how you felt about it. I said, sure, Mr. Garfield, whatever I can do, you know, help make this show happy. I said, that's what I'm here for. And he said, well, watching you out there, and he said, your color doesn't go with the rest of the people in the show. My color? Yeah, well, you don't look Negro. I said, well, I don't know what to say, sir. I said, but what do you want me to do? Am I fired? He said, no, we're not going to fire you. But he said, there is. I'd like to have you made up, makeup man come in and put some darker makeup on you. You mind? No, I don't mind at all, you know. Hell, I'd been sitting out there in that damn sun every day, you know, trying to get darker as I could, you know. In that golf ball, man, I'd play every place they had a golf course, you know, so I could get out there and walk in the sun and get dark. So he said, no, you don't mind? I said, no. He said, okay. So he brought one of the dancers in. There were three dancers. I'm trying to think of their names. It must be on the bill here or something.
Yeah, it's probably on there.
There were three dancers in the show. And it might have been one of the men chorus line. I don't know. They had some of them. But anyway, those three guys, one of them came in, and he was...
Were these guys the Hi-Hatters?
The Hi-Hatters!
Artie Brandon, Myrtle Fortune, and Millie Monroe.
Right. So, ain't that something? Ain't that something? Look at that.
Right there in the program. So those are the three, so they brought the three dancers in.
Millie Monroe, ain't that something? So anyway, he said to the makeup man, he says, just about that guy's color. So they put it on me, and I didn't know I had it on, you know. They put blackface on you, you ain't gonna know you got blackface on. You can't see unless you go in the mirror. So here I am in a white suit, you know, and doing my number out there with Dorothy Dandridge, the brown skin gal in the calico gown. I'll never forget, ever forget that scene. I'm out there and I'm moving around with Dorothy and dancing and singing to her. And I look down in a pit and Duke is like,
Paula, for the brown skin gal in the calico gown.
He can't believe what he's seeing. I thought my zipper was open on my pants, you know, because I had like tails.
But it was because
you had the tails, uh-huh. You know, so I'm dancing around, I'm looking, zipping, what the hell is he looking at me like that for? When he'd go away and she'd dance over there, you know, and then come back to me, he would be watching me. Oh, what the hell is he looking at me like that for, you know? I'm sounding all right. I get back during the intermission, and I'm in my dressing room. He comes popping in there, I'll never forget. He says, who in the hell do you think you are, Al Jolson? I'll never. I said, Gubby. I said, I have nothing to do with it. You got to talk to Mr. Garfield. He came in and told me. He just turned around, never said another word, flipped out of there. It wasn't 5 minutes that Garfield came in. Mm. Mr. Jeffries, he said, just do what you were doing before. Forget about the makeup.
That's great.
So I did the whole show, you know, with just, you know, normal, regular makeup that I would use with my color.
Well, land of cotton, Lyle is out of style. Honey child, jump for joy. Don't you grieve, little Eve. All the hounds, I do believe, have been killed. Ain't you thrilled? Jump for joy.